In the quest to capture the universe's awe-inspiring beauty, one tool stands as a gatekeeper between the cosmos and our cameras: filters. Hey everyone, it's Tony with Hidden Light Photography, and today we're going to be learning about astrophotography filters, which are the key to turning your night sky images from good to breathtaking. So if you haven't done so yet, hit that subscribe button. I don't want you to miss out on any valuable information. Now let's jump on in and learn about filters. Filters aren't just accessories. They're essential tools that enhance contrast, reduce light pollution, and bring out the delicate details of distant galaxies and nebula. Light pollution filters are the urban astronomer's best friend. They suppress artificial light, allowing the true colors of the cosmos to shine through. Here's how it works. Light, simply put, is wavelengths of excited photons. The source of the light determines the wavelength of the light emitted, and artificial light, or light pollution, has its own wavelength of light. The light pollution filter simply acts as a filter, similar to sifting for gold through running sand or dirt through different layers of screens, which progressively get smaller. These filters will filter out the wavelength of light emitted by the artificial sources by a screening process that blocks those unwanted wavelengths of light from passing through to our camera. Narrowband filters are like a laser focus for your camera, isolating specific wavelengths of light emitted by deep sky objects. These filters are perfect for capturing the intricate details of emission nebula, even from light-polluted areas. Let's take a closer look. If we examine the red spectrum of light wavelengths, we see that the red spectrum has a wavelength from roughly 600 nanometers to about 700 nanometers. Hydrogen alpha, or HA, is at the wavelength of right around 656 nanometers, and a narrowband filter will focus directly in that area. The bandpass of a filter is how much of the specified wavelength will be allowed to pass. With a narrowband filter, you can have a bandpass of 3 nanometers up to 12 nanometers. This means that a narrowband filter with a bandpass of 3 nanometers in hydrogen alpha will focus in the 656 nanometer range of wavelengths and have a tolerance of 3 nanometers within that range. Anything outside of the allowed wavelength will be filtered out and not make it to the camera sensor. The same concept works with the other colors as well: blue, green, or even oxygen 3 and sulfur 2. They just operate on different wavelengths. If you examine this image of NGC 7380 Wizard Nebula, here's the red channel without the use of any filter, and here's the same target, only this time utilizing a 3 nanometer narrowband filter showing the hydrogen alpha channel. Side by side, the difference is amazing. Broadband filters enhance the contrast in galaxies and reflection nebula. While less selective than narrowband filters, the broadband variety excels in clarity and contrast. Broadband filters work exactly the same as narrowband, but they cover a wider range of the specified spectrum and have a higher bandpass tolerance than their narrowband counterparts. Selecting the right filter depends on your target object, light pollution levels, and personal goals. My personal advice, and what I follow, is use broadband for galaxy imaging as well as reflection nebula, and use narrowband for emission nebula. Filters can truly unlock the potential of your astrophotography, bringing the wonders of the universe to your fingertips. Experiment, explore, and don't forget to share your discoveries with our growing astro community. So I hope that you found this useful. If you did, do me a favor. That channel icon that just popped up, hit that channel icon and subscribe. I don't want you to miss out on any upcoming content. Drop a comment in the comment section. Did you learn anything new? What questions do you have? What filters are you currently using if you're using filters? And then check out that next video. Until the next time, clear skies.